Hi everybody, it's Susan Rashan, the Techie Mentor. Thank you so much for stopping by for this week's video blog. And the topic today is really about what a virtual assistant is and what a virtual assistant is not. I feel that there's several misconceptions about what a virtual assistant is. One of those is that a virtual assistant is an employee, and a virtual assistant is not an employee. They are actually a business owner. So when people are looking to hire, I'm using the word hire here, I know, hire a virtual assistant, sometimes they ask for a resume. And a resume is not something that a business owner has. A business owner has testimonials or references, if you will, that they can supply anybody who's looking to connect with them or maybe hire them to help them grow their business. So as a virtual assistant, if somebody asks you for a resume, what I recommend that you do is that you would simply let them know that you'll be happy to supply them with testimonials or references, as you are a business owner and you are not applying for a position or a job, you don't have a resume. Now, if you don't have testimonials from clients at this point, you can always get references from former employers or former coworkers to speak to how you work. So don't let that stop you. If you apply for, apply for a job. If you want to apply for maybe an RFP, which stands for request or response for proposal, asking for a virtual assistant and they want a resume or they're asking for references, you can certainly get those references from a former employer or a former coworker, because those work as well. So another misconception I feel of a virtual assistant is that they're just an hourly worker, that they just work for hours. So they trade dollars for hours, but that's a misconception. Virtual assistants have an expertise that business owners need in order to grow their business. Business owners will reach a glass ceiling, if you will, where their business cannot get any bigger because they don't have any more time in the day. And it comes to a point where they have to delegate things that A, they don't know how to do, which a lot of times is technology, or B, things they don't want to do. Things like bookkeeping, maybe things like social media. Each one of those things, social media, bookkeeping, technology, they're an expertise. So a VA is not just an hourly worker, they are somebody that provides a needed expertise to business owners so the business owners can grow and flourish. So that's a big misconception I feel as well. A virtual assistant is also somebody who partners with their clients within their business. They get to know you, they get to help you, and they get to help you understand how to run your business and, again, make it grow and give you free time, you being the client, give you more free time to do what you do best, whatever that is or whatever you're passionate about. So again, a virtual assistant is not an employee. They are a business owner. They may subcontract for other business owners, but they're still a subcontractor, not an employee, which means they don't have resumes. They have references or testimonials to give that will speak to their character, their ethics, and how they work. So I hope you enjoyed this short video on what a virtual assistant is and what a virtual assistant is not. Another video that I will do will be talking about using the title of virtual assistant, which I feel is a very broad term, because a lot of times people believe that a virtual assistant just means someone who has an administrative background, which we all know is not true. So feel free to stop by my website and subscribe to my YouTube blog, or feel free if you're on my YouTube channel to also subscribe here. And you can also step over to thetechiementor.com. I have all kinds of great information over there, including free forms and information for both virtual assistants and business owners. And I look forward to seeing you guys next week. If you have any comments, please feel free to leave those below here, and I will make sure that I read and respond to each. Thank you, everybody. See you next week. Bye.